So, as some of you may know, recently Roblox actually went down, and it stayed down for about 3 days, and we didn't really get a lot of information as to why the outage happened. But Roblox is finally back up, and in this video, I'm gonna be talking about why it actually went down. So anyways, let's get right into the video. But before we get into that, if you haven't already, make sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe. But anyways, as I said, let's get right into the video. So this is a post that David Baszucki actually made regarding the outage, and I'll just read it out for you. As most of the Roblox community is aware, we recently experienced an extended outage across our platform. We are sorry for the length of time it took us to restore service. A key value at Roblox is respect the community, and in this case, we apologize for the inconvenience to our community. On Thursday afternoon, October 28th, users began having trouble connecting with our platform. This immediately became our highest priority. Teams began working around the clock to identify the source of the problem and get things back to normal. This was an especially difficult outage in that it involved a combination of several factors. A core system in our infrastructure became overwhelmed, prompted by a subtle bug in our backend service communications while under heavy load. This was not due to any peak in external traffic or any particular experience. Rather, the failure was caused by the growth in number of servers in our data centers. The result was that most services at Roblox were unable to effectively communicate and deploy. Due to the difficulty in diagnosing the actual bug, recovery took longer than any of us would have liked. Upon successfully identifying this root cause, we were able to resolve the issue through performance tuning, reconfiguration, and scaling back some of the load. We were fully able to restore service as of this afternoon. So basically what happened is since Roblox is getting more and more popular, they're increasing the number of servers, and you know, Roblox was coded a very long time ago. So apparently the core system had some kind of difficulty keeping up, and all of the data centers, the data centers probably stopped responding. And it took as Roblox mentions here, it took a lot of time to diagnose the actual bug, so that's why the recovery took longer. We will publish a post-mortem with more details once we've completed our analysis, along with the actions we'll be taking to avoid such issues in the future. In addition, we will implement a policy to make our creator community economically whole as a result of this outage. There are more details on this to come. As part of our respect the community value, we will continue to be transparent in our post-mortem. To the best of our knowledge, there has been no loss of player persistence data, and your Roblox experience should now be fully back to normal. You can always contact our support team if you experience any hiccups using Roblox now or in the future. We are grateful for your patience and support of our players, developers, and partners during this time. That is basically it. Now, one important thing I should mention for all the all of the devs and those kind of people. First of all, for the people who placed an ad that I was supposed to be displayed during the outage, they will get a refund. Now, as for some of the devs that lost money during the outage, Roblox will try to work on getting them some kind of compensation. But yeah, that's basically pretty much it. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like on it and subscribe. But anyways, I'm gonna see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.